I'm so glad that you not his chick. She wanted a nigga, ain't got the right one. I wanted a bag, she looking like fun. Pull up on me, baby, and spend the night. They saying I'm sprung, they right.
I can't let you go without me.
Shawty got me. Wait, no, little mama tryna lock me. It can't be nobody if it's not me. I'm in the same spot that you dropped me.
I can't let you go without me.
Shawty got me.
And welcome to this Primark makeup video. So I was asking about what content you guys want to see, and someone commented and said that they'd love me to try out some Primark makeup because I normally use more premium brands in my videos. So I was like, actually, do you know what, that's a really good idea. I haven't tried any of the Primark makeup, so I'm not too sure what I'm expecting, but let's see. So let's get started and let's apply the foundation. So it was quite hard for me to pick this shade out. I wasn't too sure about the shades. The shades aren't that great, but I tend to find that with cheaper makeup, you tend to not have like the variety of shades. So this shade is in Cinnamon 13. It was £2.50. I'm gonna apply this with a sponge. So it's a little bit dark, but well, actually, you know, it's blending out quite nicely. But the one that was lighter than this was like too light, so this was my only option. Be fair, I feel like it's blending in, it's not that bad. So the coverage, it actually isn't that bad now I've got it on. I quite like the texture on the skin, it doesn't look too dry. I quite like it when I get a sheen. So I quite like the colour actually now I've got it all over as well. So this foundation is called the Perfect Finish Foundation. It's got a natural finish to it and it says it's a medium to full coverage. So I think you can definitely build it up. I quite like the coverage. The coverage is quite full, but I think I can definitely see the potential that you could build it up. So this particular foundation, I would say it's quite good, so give that one a go. The next one is the concealer. So this is a medium coverage. It just says liquid concealer. It's in the shade Honey 11, and this was £2. The texture when you're applying it is quite thin. I can tell that it's not got great coverage, but I feel like it will do the job. Again, I would have probably gone for a bit of a darker concealer, but actually saying that, I think that it's so light coverage that you can't actually tell the colour. But just when I was looking at the shades in store, I probably would have gone for a little bit of a darker shade, but actually this blends in quite nicely. I don't think you can really tell that I've got it on. I think it's got a bit, the coverage is a bit too sheer on it. I mean, I don't think I really needed a concealer that much, but I think that it's quite sheer. So, I mean, if you're looking for a concealer that has got a little bit more coverage, I probably wouldn't go for this, especially if you have got quite dark under eyes or you want a really intense highlight. I don't think that this is something that I would recommend. So for this one, I think I'm gonna say I would avoid this one. Next up is this illuminating highlighter. So this was £3. It just says Nude Glow Illuminating Highlighter Drops. I don't even think it comes in a shade. Maybe the shade is, oh wait, it says here. So it's Shade Desire. Comes with like this tip, so you can kind of squeeze the product out. So I'm gonna do a couple dots, blend that out with my finger. Oh, it's quite bright, isn't it? It's a little bit more, now I'm looking in the mirror, it's a little bit more like glittery rather than shimmery. I don't know how I feel about that. I thought it would be like, not even like a shimmer, like a fine, like a really finely milled shimmer. But I mean, it does the job, like it does look illuminated. I probably would say it's a bit too glittery. Is more glittery than like shimmery highlight. So if you don't like glitter, I would definitely stay away from this one. It's quite pretty. I think it's occasional wear. I don't think I'd wear this every day, and it's not just because of the glitter, it's just because I just don't think it gives enough highlight. I would definitely wear this on occasion, but I don't think I would wear this every day. I think that there's a little bit too much glitter and not enough shimmer in it for me. I don't mind glitter, but I just think I could get a better application with something else. But I mean, for the price and the purpose, I think it works. So I'm gonna give this one a no. I think that you probably have to use something else and layer on top of it or underneath it to kind of get a really kind of like highlighted look. I think that this kind of just looks like how the foundation looked before, and I think that you could get a better result with a different product. So next up is the bronzer. So this is called Bronze Glow. It's a matte bronzing powder. This was £2 and it's in the shade Sunset. So I'm just gonna go straight in with my brush, pick up some product, and let's see what this is like. Oh, I quite like this. So I'm gonna give this product a yes. I definitely think this is a worthwhile product for you guys to try out. It's £2, you can't go wrong. I think the color's really good. I think the undertone of it is quite nice as well. It's not too of a gray undertone, which means that sometimes it can look a bit dirty and a bit muddy on the skin. I think that you kind of get a nice dimension from it. It's really smooth, really easy to apply. And I actually really like this product. So I definitely think that I'll be using that one again. So my base is all done now, so I'm going to go in with some mascara. So I'm going to go in with this mascara, it's called False Lash Queen, and let's see what this does for my lashes. So to be fair, I never really find a mascara that I absolutely love, so it'll be interesting to see what I think of this one. So the brush is okay, it's not too bad, I feel like it's lifting my lashes. I like the fact that the formula is really black. I hate a mascara that's like, says it's black but it's not. Kind of grey, build it up, go back in on the other side, give it a few wiggles, let's see what this looks like. Always get mascara up there. Lashes. So I'm not entirely obsessed with this. I don't think that it's that great. I don't think it's really bad, but if you're just looking for a standard mascara, I mean, you can't really go wrong. I think it was like £3, but for me, I would prefer just to get something that works a little bit better. So I really like the NARS Climax mascara. I think that's really, really good. That manages to lift my lashes up. And I also like the MAC in Extreme Dimension mascara. I feel like that really lifts my lashes up as well. I just don't really think that I get much from this. So for this one, if you're looking for just a standard mascara, absolutely fine, but I wouldn't shout about this one. So last but not least, I have the Shimmer Glaze Gloss. Now you guys know I love a gloss. I normally put a gloss on in a video rather than a lipstick. I like a gloss that has a little bit of colour, but I don't mind something that's just got a bit of shimmer as well. So for this particular one, it is called Haze. It was £2, so let's have a go and see what this is like. I've now got the lip gloss on. I mean, I don't think the colour's that bad. It's probably a bit more pink than I'd usually wear, but it actually worked quite well, I think. As for the texture, I'm not too sure. It feels a bit gritty. I like it when you can feel like a really smooth texture in a lip gloss. I feel like something like this, over time, as it starts to wear off, it's gonna leave like little bits on the lip, and I don't really like the thought of that. So that's one of these ones that you can have to keep checking in the mirror, that you haven't got kind of like that line around your lip when it starts to wear away. So for that, I probably wouldn't wear this. So this one's gonna have to have a no from me. So we've now come to the end of the video where I was trying out Primark makeup. So all in all, I spent £12.50, which I think is a bargain. I think if you're on a budget, this is a really good brand for you guys to think about and kind of pick up and use. On the whole, I don't think the shade ranges are that good. If you're of a deeper skin tone, I think you'll struggle to find a shade. However, I did find a shade, and I think the ones that I did use work for me. So the products I would definitely recommend would be the foundation and the bronzer. And as for the rest, I would probably just save my money and try and see if I could purchase something else of a little bit of better quality. Try maybe a couple other drugstore brands. I know there's a couple brands out there that do really cheap stuff if you're on a budget, and they obviously help a lot if you're looking to save some pennies as well. So if you like this video, give me a like, give me a comment if you've got any comments on the products that I've used, or if you want any more information. But also, if you've got any other ideas or videos that you want me to see, definitely comment it down below. And thank you so much for watching. Mwah!